Mark Watson and Henning Venn are in Argentina on their road trip to Rio. They're on their way to meet Antonio Ratin, the Argentinian player famously sent off in the 1966 World Cup against England. They're meeting him at the Bombonera Stadium.
Señor Ratin.
Sir.
Mucho gusto.
Hola, me llamo Henning.
Ratin played for Boca his entire 14-year career, so for him, this stadium is like a second home.
God, this is brilliant. I love the way the tunnels come properly out onto the pitch here.
Esta es la famosa Bombonera.
Wow.
Wow.
Esta tiene una acústica única. Yo jugué en varios países, en varios estadios, pero la acústica que tiene la Bombonera es única.
A pretty intense atmosphere for Ratin, and he was in front of a few intense crowds in his time. Not least, of course, that day in Wembley, England in 1966. Dismissed by the German referee, he refused to leave the field. The restart of the game was delayed by 8 minutes, and eventually England beat the 10-man Argentinian team, and of course went on to win the tournament. So, with a German referee and England as the opposition, Mark and Henning have got a good reason to hear what the Argentinian has to say about that day.
Me expulsaron a mí. Por pedir el intérprete me expulsa. Yo no hice ningún foul violento, ni le falté respeto al juez ni a nada. Solamente quería intérprete porque el árbitro alemán cobraba todo a favor de Inglaterra.
The language barrier was making the situation worse, and eventually he was persuaded to leave the field. And although it wasn't captured on camera, it's a big talking point because he decided to sit down on the red carpet that just so happened to belong to the Queen of England.
Aparte, cuando me expulsan a mí, yo inconsciente fui y me senté en la alfombra de la reina. Y luego de estar unos 7-8 minutos sentado en la alfombra de la reina, que la reina no estaba, estaba el palco vacío.
So his point is, the Queen wasn't there, so someone had to sit on it. Why not Ratin? Yeah. Apart from the fact that the army had to be called in to diffuse tensions afterwards.
No, luego fui caminando hacia el vestuario, porque el viejo Wembley no tenía túnel, hacia el vestuario, me tiraban chocolate aireado, que era novedad para nosotros, los argentinos, que no lo conocíamos. Y luego, cuando llegué al banderín del corne y le retorcí la bandera, le apreté la bandera inglesa que flameaba, sí, yo creo que no tenía por qué haber agarrado la bandera y haber retorcido. Después, sentarme en la alfombra roja de la reina, estaba muy cómodo, estaba muy lindo. La reina no estaba, aproveché.
Yeah, fair enough. Naturally, yeah. Yeah.
Apparently they are very nice red carpets. Yeah. Oh well, I'll pass on the apology about the flag to my dad. He's still a bit cross about that.